Lake Natron in Tanzania is one of the most serene lakes in Africa, but it's also the source of some of the most phantasmagorical photographs ever captured. Images that look as though living animals had instantly turned to stone. The alkaline water in Lake Natron has a pH as high as 10.5 and is so caustic it can burn the skin and eyes of animals that aren't adapted to it. Despite some media reports, the animals don't simply turn to stone and die after coming into contact with the lake's water. In fact, Lake Natron's alkaline waters support a thriving ecosystem of salt marshes, freshwater wetlands, flamingos and other wetland birds, tilapia, and the algae on which large flocks of flamingos feed. Supercell is the name given to a continuously rotating updraft deep within a severe thunderstorm, and looks downright scary. They are usually isolated storms which can last for hours, and sometimes can split into two, with one storm going to the left of the wind and one to the right. They can spout huge amounts of hail, rain, and wind, and are often responsible for tornadoes. Supercells are often carriers of giant hailstones, and although they can occur anywhere in the world, they're most frequent in the Great Plains of the US. This amazing cloud phenomenon is known as hole punch clouds or Fallstreaked Holes, and they are strange holes in the cloud layer. A Fallstreaked Hole happens when it's cold enough to freeze water, but there's not enough water to form a proper cloud. A weird domino effect happens, and you end up with these insane formations. They're often mistaken for UFOs or the apocalypse. Covered in spiders' webs, these cocoon trees in Sindh, Pakistan, are an unexpected result of floods that hit the region in 2010. To escape from the rising waters, millions of spiders crawled up into trees. The scale of the flooding and the slow rate at which the waters receded have left many trees completely enveloped in spiders' webs. Although slowly killing the trees, the phenomenon is seemingly helping the local population. People in Sindh have reported fewer mosquitoes than they would have expected given the amount of stagnant water in the area. It is thought the mosquitoes are getting caught in the spiders' webs, reducing their numbers and the associated risk of malaria. Raining animals is a rare meteorological phenomenon in which flightless animals fall from the sky. Such occurrences have been reported in many countries throughout history. One hypothesis is that tornadic waterspouts sometimes pick up creatures, such as fish or frogs, and carry them for up to several miles. However, this aspect of the phenomenon has never been witnessed by scientists. Before you make any assumptions, this photo is not photoshopped. Amazingly, the goats in these photos are real and do in fact climb on trees with uncanny skill. Found in the small village of Tamri in Morocco, these goats climb argan trees in search for food. Argan berries are about the best food a Tamri goat could imagine, and to reach the fruit requires them to be adept in an extraordinary balancing act that's quite unexpected from a hoofed animal. However, this unique phenomenon isn't all that's remarkable about these goats. After digesting the berries, the goats leave behind droppings that contain large kernels of the seeds they consume. These kernels are extracted from the manure, washed, and ground-pressed to produce argan oil. From July 25th to September 23rd, 2001, red rain sporadically fell on the southern Indian state of Kerala. Heavy downpours occurred in which the rain was colored red, staining clothes with an appearance similar to that of blood. Yellow, green, and black rain was also reported. It was initially suspected that the rains were colored by fallout from a hypothetical meteor burst, but a study commissioned by the government of India found that the rains had been colored by airborne spores from a locally prolific terrestrial alga. At the beginning of the wet season, the red crabs on Christmas Island off the northwest coast of Australia begin a spectacular migration from the forest to the coast in order to breed and release eggs into the sea. Each year, about 43.7 million red crabs move in masses. Local authorities close most of the roads for the week so as to not interfere with the migration. Blue holes are an amazing natural phenomenon occurring around the world in coastal regions. They're usually underwater caves or sinkholes, and though they can be on land, the ones that formed in the water are obviously more spectacular. The name comes from the dramatic color contrast between shallow waters around them and the depth inside the holes. Most of the blue holes were formed during ice ages, when the water level was lower than today, and they were initially caves. After the sea level rose, the cave sank and formed the deep holes. These columns are so perfect, they almost look artificial. Millions of years ago, they were lava plateaus, which over time cooled and fractured to create the stunning facade we see today. Located near the city of Osoyoos in British Columbia, Canada's Spotted Lake draws visitors from around the world. The Spotted Lake has a very high concentration of numerous different minerals, such as magnesium sulfate, calcium, and sodium sulfates. It also contains extremely high concentrations of 8 other minerals, as well as some small doses of 4 others, such as silver and titanium. Most of the water in the lake evaporates over the summer, leaving behind large spots of minerals. Depending on the mineral composition left behind, the spots will be of white, pale yellow, green, or blue in color. The Catatumbo Lighting is an atmospheric phenomenon in Venezuela. It occurs only over the mouth of the Catatumbo River, where it empties into Lake Maracaibo. It originates from a mass of storm clouds at a height of more than 1 kilometer and occurs during 140 to 260 nights a year, 10 hours per day, and up to 280 times per hour. Twice a year, between the months of February and March, the Atlantic Ocean waters roll up the Amazon River in Brazil, generating the longest wave on Earth. The phenomenon, known as pororoca, is caused by the tides of the Atlantic Ocean which meet the mouth of the river. This tidal bore generates waves up to 12 feet high, which can last for over half an hour. These amazing ice spikes, generally known as penitentes due to their resemblance to processions of white-hooded monks, can be found on mountain glaciers and vary in size dramatically, from a few centimeters to 5 meters in height. Initially, the sun's rays cause random dimples on the surface of the snow. Once such a dimple is formed, sunlight can be reflected within the dimple, increasing the localized sublimation. As this accelerates, deep troughs are formed, leaving peaks of ice standing between them. Like phenomena out of a fantasy film, FireWhirls are mysterious and highly dangerous tornadoes. Known as fire devils, fire tornadoes, or even firenadoes, they can come in different sizes and intensities and are formed in different ways depending on environmental conditions. The FireWhirls is a rare natural phenomenon that occurs when a fire, combined by certain air temperature and currents, forms a whirl that rises into the air like a tornado. They can be actual whirlwinds that disengage from the flames, or else can become a vortex of flame. The FireWhirl usually occurs during bushfires,